Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a tutorial on balance sheet. Now, the word balance sheet is like very common general term when you get into the commerce background. See, the balance sheet is one of the most important financial statements and is useful for doing accounting analysis and modeling. So what is balance sheet definition? See, balance sheet is basically a snapshot of company's financial position at a given point of time. Balance sheet reports the amount of the company's assets, liabilities, and you can say the stockholders' equity. The assets are current assets and long-term assets. Liabilities are current liabilities and long-term liabilities. And stockholders' equity includes common stock and retained earnings. This is what something it looks like. This is assets, this is your liability and stockholders' equity, current liability, long-term liability, and this is your stockholders' equity. Remember this one simple equation, the most important equation while forming the balance sheet. Assets is always equal to liability plus shareholders' equity. Let's get started. See, unlike income statement, balance sheet are much less complicated. However, there are many items you need to include under few heads. And balance sheet portrays the overall picture of the company's financial affairs altogether. So balance sheet cannot be formed without first setting up the income statement, because we need to know that the retained earnings from the income statement, through the income statement we can assert in the net profit, and the portion of the net profit that is not distributed among the shareholders is known as retained earnings. So let's begin with balance sheet structure. Now, how does the structure work? Assets are arranged on the left-hand side of the balance sheet. And you can say this is your assets on the left-hand side, and the liability and the shareholders' equity. And shareholders' equity, that is on the right-hand side, would be on the right-hand side. However, in most of the cases, companies put the assets first and they set up the liabilities at the bottom of the shareholders' equity. The total assets should be equal to the total liabilities and the total shareholders' equity. So assets will be equal to liability plus shareholders' equity. Now, balance sheet format is like, you know, current assets, current liability, long-term assets, long-term liability, and shareholders' equity, which we saw in that picture. The first is we'll be discussing is current assets. Current assets are expected to be consumed, sold, or converted into cash either in 1 year or in the operating cycle, whichever is longer. So, an operating cycle is basically an average time it takes to convert an investment in inventory back into cash. So current assets are presented in order of a liquidity. There are few of them, of the current assets. The first is cash and cash equivalents. Cash could also include an amount required to be held for the deposit to satisfy the terms of lending agreement. Cash equivalents are securities, example like treasury bills that have term of less than or equal to 90 days. The next is the short-term investments. Short-term investment. In that case, short-term marketable security primarily include bond investments, capital stock investments, short-term marketable securities, and are not ready as money in your account. But they provide added cushion if some immediate need were to arise. The next is inventories. Now, in this case, inventories consist of merchandise a business owns but has not sold, so classified as current asset because investor assumes that inventory can be sold in the near future, turning it to be cash. Also, you know, the next thing that we can discuss is the trade and the other receivable. So you can say the debtors, money that is owed to the company by the customer, and there are some of the prepaid and the accrued income. Sometimes a business, you know, will have to pay for the goods or the service before they actually receive the product. Expenses that have been paid in the current fiscal period but that has not been subtracted from the revenue until a subsequent fiscal period. So other current assets also include like derivative assets, current income tax assets, assets held for sale. Let's have a look on that. This is how it looks like: cash, cash equivalents, accounts receivable, inventories, and this is your total current asset. In the similar fashion, current liability works, which is our second case. Current liabilities are basically the probability or probable future payments of the assets or services that a firm is obligated to make as a result of the previous operation. And these obligations are expected to require to use the existing current assets or creation of the other current assets, which includes like accounts payable, short-term debts, its current maturities, you can say current maturities of long-term debts, LTD, current maturity of long-term debts, and that is basically any portion of the long-term debt that has to be repaid within a year of the balance sheet date, and is reclassified from the non-current liability section to the current liability section of the title. And then there is a thing called unearned income, unearned revenue, which is unearned revenue is created when the customers pay for the services of the products before their delivery. The next one is close enough to other accrued liabilities, which is basically, you can say they could include money owed to the employees as a salary or bonus of the company that has not yet been paid. The next is what we are going to discuss over here is the third is long-term liability. Now, in case of long-term liability, long-term assets are typically the physical assets of that the company own and are employed in the production process of the firm and have a useful life greater than 1 year. Long-term assets are not for sale for the firm's customer. They are not basically an inventory. Long-term assets include tangible assets like office furniture, buildings. Then they have natural resources like the assets that have an economic value derived from the earth and used over the period of time. Intangible assets, which is the third thing. The assets that have no physical existence and they cannot be felt or touched or seen, like copyright, patent, trademark, franchisee, goodwill, and so on and so forth. So long-term assets, you can say, they are generally reported at their carrying value, the book value. If the assets has lost its revenue generating ability, it may be written down, like assets impairment, amount of the written down is recorded as loss. The fourth one that we need to discuss is the long-term liability, LTL. Long-term liabilities are obligations that are not expected to require the use of the current assets or not expected to create current liabilities within 1 year or the normal operating cycle, whichever is longer. In most of the cases, it contains long-term debt. Long-term debt is subject to various covenants or restrictions. Long-term, debt can be obtained from many sources and may differ in the structure or the interest and principal payments. And the claim creditors have an assets of the firm. So bonds are contracted between the borrowers and the lenders that obligates the bond issuers to make payments to the bondholder over the period of time. The next thing that we need to discuss is the shareholders' equity. That is the fifth thing, shareholders' equity. Shareholders' equity is the residual interest of the stockholders in the assets of the corporations. There are two primary sources of the equity, that is the paid-in capital and retained earnings. The paid-in capital, I'll show you a graph of the same. The total owner's equity, it includes paid-up capital and retained earnings. This is your profit, basically. Paid-in capital includes your preferred stock, that is preference shares and common stock. In case of preferred stock, it includes the value at par, or if any additional in capital is coming, that is the company is calling. In case of common stock, again, the same thing goes around. And each of this common stock conveys certain rights like to attend the stockholders meeting, like directors on the vote or any other matter, presumptive right, and so on and so forth. Now, how to read the balance sheet? See, balance sheet provides very useful information about the company's financial affairs. As an investor, you need to know that how to read the balance sheet. There are steps that can help you to read balance sheet. The first thing is you need to know the balance sheet's equation. That is the first and the foremost thing that you need to learn. You need to see whether the total assets and the total liabilities and the total shareholders equity are equal. That is, over this assets is equal to liability plus shareholders equity, as you can see in the above one. Then you will look at the current assets. This assets will give an idea about the liquidity of the company and where the company expects to liquidate the asset from. And this assets can easily be converted into cash. Then you should, follow the non-current assets, which includes fixed assets and intangible assets. Then you need to learn about the liabilities of the company. About the liability of the company, they can be both current and the non-current liability. And the last step is to look through the shareholders' equity. So this is how you should go about. Check it out, the retained earnings, and compare it with the net profit, and you will get an idea about how much the dividend is being supposed to be paid. So let's make a final conclusion out of this. Learning to read a balance sheet is important if you want to be successful as an investor, and it starts with pulling out a balance sheet of a company and reading it through and thorough. If it's your first annual reporting, then please do not get intimidated. Stay put. You will master the balance sheet analysis over the period of time.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.